Welcome to another session of CAT18 Slot 2. The idea is to make you understand alternate methods of solving which are normally more effective. It may sound difficult right now, but as when you practice, I'm sure you'll be better. Also, one more important thing in CAT, you should be able to pick up the easy questions and solve. A lot of people waste a lot of time on tough questions. A key strategy in a paper is to pick up the easy questions and solve. Okay, like this. So this is the first question for today. So area of a rectangle. Now if you have a rectangle, length, breadth, perimeter 25, that is square of the perimeter. So if I say A plus B are the length and breadth, square of the perimeter, and area AB is 1:25. So you can make out that A plus B should be somewhere of 5, multiple of 5 or a factor of 5. Length plus breadth. So look at options where length plus breadth gives you multiple of 5. Look at 1 plus 4, 5, 2 plus 9, 11, 1 plus 3, 4, 3 plus 8, 11. So most likely the answer will be 1 plus 4, 5 because of 5 here. I'm not saying it is definite, but that's the first thing I will start with and I'll check. So breadth is 1, length is 4, area will become 4 into 1, 4. And A plus B the whole square, that is twice A plus B the whole square, whatever, will give you 2 into 1 plus 4, 5, 10, the whole square. So it becomes 4:100, which becomes 1:25. Simple, get the answer. Just use the option and you get the answer immediately. And very simple sum. I mean, you have ample time to solve. Even if you pick up a few easy sums in the exam and solve, you will get enough percentile to clear the cutoffs. The key is to pick up the easy sums. And normally the easy sums will take much lesser time than a tougher time sum. Another sum, log. Since there's a base S out here, so we have to convert everything to in terms of S. Okay, since there's a base S. So if I have P cube is equal to S raised to 6, so you can make out P will be equal to S raised to 6 upon 3 or S square. Same way, Q will be equal to S raised to 6 upon 4 or S raised to 1.5. Same way, R will be equal to S raised to 6 by 5 or S raised to 1.2. Substitute out here. Base S raised to 2 into S raised to 1.5 into S raised to 1.2, which becomes S raised to 4.7. 4.7 goes outside. Log of S to the base S is 1. So we should get the answer is 4.7. From the options, you can make out the answer is 4. Just should know the basic properties of log, and you should know everything should be converted to base. The base becomes important. Remember in a previous case also, we had to convert the base to 100 denominator in a previous sum. So logs are simple. Just remember not to leave it for option. Just solve simple sums of logs, and I think that should suffice for the exam. They don't ask too many complicated sums in logs. If you look at next sum, Gopal borrows X from Ankit at rupees 8. So he borrows X at 8%. He adds Y, and then both X plus Y gives a 10%. End of the year, after returning Ankit's dues, the net interest retained by Gopal is same as accrued by Ankit. So if you look at, he gave this 8% also at 10%. So from this, Gopal earns 8%. Ankit earns 2% here. Sorry, Gopal earns 2%, Ankit earns 8%. Right? Because he gave it a 10%, he gains 2%. So balance left is 6% is what Ankit earns net. And apart from that, Gopal earns 10% on Y. Here, Ankit has 6% extra. And here, Gopal has 10%. So if the ratio of the interest earned by them is 6:10, and remember, we need to have the same amount. So 6% of X should be equal to 10% of Y, because the interest earned should be same. So automatically we get X upon Y as 10 upon 6 or 5 upon 3. So we know X and Y are 5 upon 3. Now when you give Y extra, now he gives X plus 2Y, that means he gives Y extra, he gets 150 rupees interest. Now 150 is a 10%. That means the principal Y has to be 1500. Remember, 10% of Y gives you 150. So y should be 1500. If y is 1500, we know x and y are in the ratio 5:3. So automatically x is 2500. So total x and y will become 4000 as the answer. So that will be, if you understand this, you don't have to form equations and solve. Just simple calculations will help. Even the 6% of x and 10% of y, you can actually directly make 6 cents. Therefore, the principles will be in the ratio of 5:3 or 10:6 or 5:3. You need not make equations. I'm just making equations to help you understand. But a lot of things can be solved by simple ratios, which will give you the answer faster. This is some the idea which has come in the previous CAT also. I mean, similar idea has come in previous CAT. So somewhere maybe going to previous CAT papers could help you a little bit in the exam. So this has come. So if you know and if you solve girl versus girl matches, suppose there are n girls. Each girl will play n minus 1 match. They'll play with each and every player. Right? So it's basically not each girl, sorry. Each girl play n minus 1 matches, but the basic idea is first girl plays with all the remaining n minus 1 players. Next, second girl play with next n minus 2. Third will play with n minus 3 and so on. You can see that. Or you say each girl plays n minus 1 matches, but there's double counting. We count both. So divide by 2 should give you 153. Either this, or you can say n minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 3 plus 1 is nothing but n into n minus 1 upon 2. Either way you take. Sum of values. Because the sum of 1 to n is n into n plus 1. Here sum of 1 to n minus 1 is n into n minus 1 upon 2. So you know n into n minus 1 is 1,306. Now if you know these squares, you know 17 square is 289, 18 square is 324. So this is somewhere will be 18 into 17. So you know n is 18. So there are 18 girls. If there are 18 girls, the number of boys in the junior level will be 43 minus 18, which will come to 25. So total matches played by boys and girls with each other will be 18 girls playing with 25 boys, will give you 450 matches. This is for the junior level. So we're looking at junior year. Now if you look at a senior level, they said boy versus boy matches is 276. Same concept, n into n minus 1 will give you 276. So n into n minus 1, if you solve it, gives you 552. Now you know that 24 square is 576, 23 square is something 529. So this is 24 into 23 because it's between 24 square and 23 square. So n becomes 24. N becomes 24 means number of boys is 24. So number of girls will become 51 minus 24, which is 27. So total matches played by boys and girls with each other will be 24 into 27. 24 square is 576. 24 threes are 72. You will get the answer is 648. So total matches by both of them put together will be 1098. Right, I hope it's clear. A water tank has inlets of two types, A and B. This is one of those two variable, two equation types. So we have 10 inlets plus of A, 10A. Plus 45B. Let A be the amount filled by A, B build up the amount filled by B. Fills in 30 minutes. Okay, fills in 30 minutes. Whereas 8A plus 18B fills in 1 hour. To compare these two, you have to make the time same. So I'll make this into 30 minutes. To make this time half, you have to double the number of inlets. So it'll be 16A. Plus 36B. Remember, if I want to reduce the time to half, the number of pipe has to double. So I notice both are giving you 30 minutes. Now we can compare A and B. So extra 6 pipes of A out here is equal to 9 pipes of B. Okay, 45 minus 36 is 9, 10 minus 16 is 6. So 6 pipes of A is equal to 9 pipes of B. Or you can say that A is 1.5 times as more efficient as B. Now if you understand that, let's take the second. So here 8 inlet pipes is of A means 8 into 1.5 inlet pipes of B. I'm converting to B. 8 into 1.5 times of B plus 18B. It makes sense to convert to same variable. This will give you 30 inlet pipes of B takes 1 hour. Now coming here, 7 into 1.5 plus 27 will give you 37.5 inlet pipes of B will take you how much time? If you look at a ratio of the pipe is 4 is to 5 or 5 is to 4, okay, the time taken will be 4/5 of 1 hour, which is 48 minutes. Because the number of pipes are increasing in a ratio of 5 is to 4, 37.5 upon 30 is 5 upon 4. So the time taken will be inversely proportional, 4 upon 5 of 1 hour, which is 48 minutes as the answer. Thank you.